When I came for studies from Bombay to Baroda, that was the first time I met. I chose to come to Baroda because my uncle knew lots of professors who were teaching at that time. And he said that if you are really serious studying art, then this is the place. So I was in JJ School of Arts, studied for a year, then decided to come. For the studies in art, I had decided that I want to do sculpture. I always liked three-dimensional form of expression. So that was, I was very clear. But in our college, in the first year, we had to do everything. Even then, my decision didn't change. He was always curious about his curiosity is like child. So still, if he comes, a new word comes while reading, he would immediately open the dictionary and find out the meaning of it. Never took anything for granted. So that is very, very curious to know lots of things. While do the travel, why the artist travels, to learn more. So whenever he went abroad, he was very curious to see the museums, art galleries, what is the things around, what is the art scene, and that must have helped him in discussion with other artists, his teachers, because he also studied in New York. So discussing with other artists, the printmakers, helps in development, of course.
You were there?
I joined him later. He had gone on Fulbright scholarship. He went to study printmaking, and that was also, he was very clear that he wants to join. And he wanted to be in New York, first of all, because lots of movements, lots of new things are happening in Big City. He was offered to go to Berkeley, but he said, no, I want to be in New York when lots of things, art scene is, one can see what is happening. So then the option of studying there was, I forgot the name of the school, it was in New York. And so that was printmaking, mainly, basically, the interest was in learning new techniques in printmaking. So, and I, of course, I had joined when his scholarship was getting over. And he had few months more, so he said, why don't you come and then we will travel together. But then he got another scholarship while he was there. He got Rockefeller Foundation scholarship. So then he said that, why don't you also join some art college? So I also joined, but a different school. It was Brooklyn Museum Art School. I was interested in learning ceramics and methods of teaching also.
Okay.
So I enjoyed it because he never wanted me to sit either at home. Because I didn't go on a scholarship. So he supported me. But then he said, even for if we are there for 3 months, join something. So in during summer time in USA, lots of interesting subjects are offered. So that time I joined one art school for just 1 month, a summer course. And then I continued. We decided to study, stay for 1 more year. I joined the full course.
Why he
was also, again, he also continued in the same as good.
Okay.
And then we traveled a lot.
Okay.
He got travel grant also. Almost across the country, from east to west coast. I never studied under him. But he has been a professor during our day-to-day life. In my subject, also he suggests many things that you can do it this way, that way. And if I'm cooking, mm-hmm. that time also you can suggest that. I mean, like, we never think that why do we put oil in while making a roti? Why do we put oil? But is it, I have seen my mother making an atta for rotis. She just put oil and water, everything together. Mm-hmm. No, it should, it is not that way. You have to put the oil, it should penetrate in all the particles of the atta. And so that makes the dough softer. Mm-hmm. Then you add water and so the roti will become soft. So that way also interesting in it thinks properly. Then when eating, then suddenly they know it. Let's say papad. Why do we eat papad? We like something crispy while eating. I thought with something crispy feels good in mind. Whenever he thought his, he can perhaps contribute or suggest something.
He was commissioned to take, there was a special exhibition on folk art, and they were to travel in Saurashtra. And then, because he belongs to Saurashtra, and as a child he had seen lots of things, interesting things, designs on walls and floors. That were getting vanished. So then he thought he must record all these things before they get completely vanished. So then photography was the best medium. And being a painter, his vision was very different. And he saw things, took photography, and then photography also became a medium for expression. And painting also, it must have helped. And so his photography, or photographs, when you see, they are so well composed. But reason was this only, that he should record things which may get vanished after a few years. But then, mainly folk art. He must have seen lots of things in childhood, which he then was not able to find when he went to take the photographs. In Rajasthan, Saurashtra, the places where lots of floor designs and wall designs were done. So those were the areas where lots of, about Bandra, Rajasthan. And in Saurashtra also, in many areas, they do designs on floor, Mulwa area. Of looking at designs which women did. Bread about those things, and then traveled those areas, up to south. Agna is in Bengal. Kolam. So those are in the south.
Does that reflect at that time in his whole design?
Yes.
But he applied those things in a very different meaning. Yes, he suggested lots of things, technical things also. Of course, that is not his medium. And my medium is clay, in this brush paint. But there also the possibilities suggested that you can do it this way. Try this. Because he is a printmaker. So he made metal plates. So he said, why don't you take a clay print from the metal plate and do something? So I used lots of his etching plates and lino cuts. By pressing the clay slab on it and removed and made plates. Screen printing he has introduced, and that was not
I may be exaggerating, but the screen printing in Tangier, that is also his contribution. Not many people know that it is this, but he thinks that it was my mistake. You can ask him. when that time, he was a teacher, I was training. And our professors decided to ek drama mate preparation karta tha ane ema ek geet aavto to ne dance pan par ek je vata hati te bengali hati ane ema pelo elo pan dance no form eta ava inya gujarat ma kare to enu anya ela dance bengali ele he thought of introducing garba in that song. And immediately after that, the project was over, drama and everything was over, we went for a study tour. At that time, the connecting train was not immediately available. So then we had to wait at the platform. Then we started dancing from those scenes of the drama. And then it continued in the college. And then during Navratri, again, we did that back. And then slowly, people also got attracted in our way of the steps which were taught. Those were mainly Saurashtra. Those became popular. the scenes in Baroda. I can't say it was a contribution.
It is initiation. Anyways, it is a contribution. If you will see.
So then you can put it in properly.
Okay.
I think it is very. The scene of Garba, which is now in Baroda, which is happening. Which is the Garba started by Jyoti in our college, and then it was getting very popular. But he had started. Sometimes I get very depressed when I go out and looking at things, the political scene. But art is a real core thing.
Still, there is something to hold.
In my subject is mainly sculpture, clay. So, because my teacher, Shankar Chandra, I like his work very much. Another professor, of course, he is a painter, Mani sir, K.D. Sudhamani. And the Western artist like Bernard Leachford, Missy Lee, English Waters. But then when I started doing more ceramics, two gurus.